The reading is from Acts 9, beginning at verse 1, the conversion of Saul. In the meantime, Saul kept up his violent threats of murder against the followers of the Lord. He went to the high priest and asked for letters of introduction to the synagogues in Damascus, so that if he should find there any followers of the way of the Lord, he would be able to arrest them, both men and women, and bring them back to Jerusalem. As Saul was approaching the city of Damascus, suddenly a light from the sky flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" "Who are you, Lord?" he asked. "I'm Jesus, whom you persecute," the voice said. "But get up and go into the city, where you will be told what you must do." The men who were traveling with Saul had stopped, not saying a word. They heard the voice, but could not see anyone. Saul got up from the ground and opened his eyes, but could not see a thing. So they took him by the hand and led him into Damascus. For 3 days he was not able to see, and during that time he did not eat or drink anything. There was a believer in Damascus named Ananias. He had a vision in which the Lord said to him, "Ananias." "Here I am, Lord," he answered. The Lord said to him, "Get ready and go to Straight Street, and at the house of Judas, ask for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He's praying, and in a vision, he has seen a man named Ananias come in and place his hands on him so that he might see again." Ananias answered, "Lord, many people have told me about this man and about all the terrible things he has done to your people in Jerusalem. And he has come to Damascus with authority from the chief priests to arrest all who worship you." The Lord said to him, "Go, because I have chosen him to serve me, to make my name known to Gentiles and kings and to the people of Israel. And I myself will show him all that he must suffer for my sake." So Ananias went, entered the house where Saul was, and placed his hands on him. "Brother Saul," he said, "the Lord has sent me, Jesus himself, who appeared to you on the road as you were coming here. He sent me so that you might see again and be filled with the Holy Spirit." At once, something like fish scales fell from Saul's eyes, and he was able to see again. He stood up and was baptized, and after he had eaten, his strength came back. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the reading from 1 Peter chapter 3, beginning at verse 13. "Who will harm you if you are eager to do what is good? But even if you should suffer for doing what is right, how happy you are. Do not be afraid of anyone, and do not worry, but have reverence for Christ in your hearts and honour him as Lord. Be ready at all times to answer anyone who asks you to explain the hope you have in you, but do it with gentleness and respect. Keep your conscience clear, so that when you are insulted, those who speak evil of your good conduct as followers of Christ will be ashamed of what they say. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if this should be God's will, than for doing evil. For Christ died for sins once and for all, a good man on behalf of sinners, in order to lead you to God. He was put to death physically, but made alive spiritually, and in his spiritual existence, he went and preached to the imprisoned spirits. They were the spirits of those who had not obeyed God when he waited patiently during the days that Noah was building his boat. The few people in the boat, 8 in all, were saved by the water, which was a symbol pointing to baptism, which now saves you. It is not the washing off of bodily dirt, but the promise made to God from a good conscience. It saves you through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone to heaven and is at the right-hand side of God, ruling over all angels and heavenly authorities and powers. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the gospel reading is from John chapter 14, beginning at verse 15. Jesus is speaking. If you love me, you will obey my commandments. I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper who will stay with you forever. He is the Spirit who reveals the truth about God. The world cannot receive him because it cannot see him or know him. But you know him because he remains with you and is in you. When I go, you will not be left all alone. I will come back to you. In a little while, the world will see me no more, but you will see me. And because I live, you also will live. When that day comes, you will know that I am in my Father and that you are in me, just as I am in you. Those who accept my commandments and obey them are the ones who love me. My Father will love those who love me. I too will love them and reveal myself to them. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, O Christ.